folks. Where Games here, and today we're going to look at a mod for Banished called the Colonial Charter Maple Harpoon. That's right, not easy to say, but easy to play, hopefully. So you can see here, we've already gone through the process of loading the mod to Banished. If you're confused about how to do that, we have a video that will show you how to do it. It's pretty easy, really. You just download a file and make sure you put it in the right place in your Banished folder, and make sure that you've got a version that allows mods, which I think by this point, hopefully they all do. And for this one, we moved up the that mod to the top of our list. So. Here we go. We're going to play a new game. Just for the sake of argument, we're going to go with an easy version in a large map, just so that we can get a hang of the mod. We're not really trying to, you know, change the world here. We're just trying to get the mod going and see what it looks like. So, my first thought was that I should take some time and familiarize myself with everything in this mod. But then, how much fun would that be? Then you wouldn't get to see me flailing around and trying to figure out what the heck I'm doing. So, that's not what you get. Instead, what you get is me trying to figure out how the mod works. So, we're just going to slow everything down here. We're going to pause for a minute. So the first thing that I can see that's fairly obvious is that we have some new boxes here. We've got alcohol production. We've got decorative items. And everything else looks the same. Of course, there's probably going to be some changes in menus and things like that. We got our paths menu there. Our standard menus. I'm just going to pop these guys open because we know we're going to need them. I just kind of like to have everything in the corners and out of the way. Oh, there's a bunch of new jobs. Okay, this is going to be some effort. Strap in, folks. Going to take a few minutes to sort all this out. Okay, so we've got our wooden house, we've got our stone house, we've got a colonial house, warm and comfortable home for a family of five. Oh, the colonial manor, which can house a family of eight, and it looks like on top of stone and logs that you also need rope to do that. I can see a coil of rope there, and there's also something called a roper up here. Not Mr. Roper from Happy Days, or sorry, from Three's Company, if you're that old. You might get that joke. And our roads and bridges, we've got our dirt road, we've got our stone road, wooden bridge, stone bridge, tunnel, not too much different there. Storage barn, we've got a stockpile, we've got a specialized stockpile, we've got our market, trading post, dry storage, stores textiles such as cotton, flax, leather, wool, rope, cotton, and tobacco leaf. So, goods in storage. Bank barn. Extra large storage building that must be built on a slope. We've got a grain silo that stores grain, and we've got a root cellar for fruits and vegetables, so like different kinds of storage devices there. All of our standard buildings that we're used to seeing, a parish house, so like a smaller church, I guess, smaller than the chapel. We've got our cemetery, we've got an abbey, houses monks who gather berries and herbs and brew ale. And we've got a back alley where deals can be made and certain needs met. I'm assuming that they mean that you can buy berries or something by certain needs. That's all we're going to say about that. In our crop menu, our food production menu, sorry, we've got crops, orchards, all the usual stuff, and we've got a water mill. We've got a windmill, we've got oil press, we've got an apiary, we've got a bakery, we've got a sugar house, and a wharf with a ship is advanced building to fish, whale, seal, and lobster on the high seas. Goodness. And a dairy, resource, oh my god. We've got a bundling shed, we've got shore house, chandlery, a glassworks, mulberry grove, a ropery. I think we're going to need one of those. Hemp and flax are bound into rope. Silkworm hut. Weavers. And our mine and our quarry, like usual. And our alcohol production. We've got an inn and garden. Brewery, winery, distillery, and a curing barn. And then we've got all kinds of lovely decorative items. Charter statues. A little bathroom privy. Flags. This is nice. Fruit trees in your town. Wild trees, decorative hedges. Fun. Okay. So, we have a rough idea what we need to do. Since we're on easy mode, we shouldn't have too much trouble making it through a couple winters. Let's just have a look and see what our setup looks like here. Kind of on a hill, not really perfect for growth, but we got a lot of room right there, so maybe we'll be all right. Got a little lake right over there. And then our river is fairly close by, so okay, we can make do with this. We've got our five houses, because we're playing on easy mode, we of course already have our five houses built. So, we're probably going to do some standard things first, because we're used to doing those, but then we'll strike out and try some new things. So we're going to throw a gatherer's hut in, just to feed people. It's what we do. Maybe even two of them. All right. And we're going to put 4 or 5 workers up to that. Get those things built, and then we'll get some of our resources gathered here. So, yeah, it's been a while since I've played. Hopefully you guys are still having fun and playing and doing the things you do. I have been up to all kinds of crazy stuff, so I apologize for not having more videos out sooner, but hey, you got one now, so quit your whining. I'm just kidding. Okay, so we're going to crank things up to high speed. And we are almost out of firewood immediately. So, let's get our woodcutter in fast. And fast mode seems very fast compared to what I'm used to. Maybe things move more quickly in this mod. Let's see how quickly our season changes on us. And stuff gets built. Oh yeah, they're cruising. Okay, so we have 5 builders out of a possible 9 at the moment, but we did tell them to build 3 buildings at the same time, so that's our own fault, really. And we're also gathering all these resources from here. Sorry, folks, it shouldn't be too long before we start getting into some crazy new buildings. We're probably going to need some fields to do that, so I have a feeling it will be next season before we really get into things. And our woodcutter's getting closer to being done. We should probably create another storage facility of some kind. So we can do a specialized stockpile for our firewood. So maybe we'll just put one right there. And now we need... Where is he now? Oh, he's way over here, the woodcutter. And, wow, 4 children instantly. Yeah, this is moving pretty fast. I think maybe the 5 is what the 10 used to be, or it seems like it. Maybe I'm wrong. And our reserve of food is not that great, and because, of course, we need to get some gatherers going here. So let's drop those down and get at least a bunch of gatherers happening. And it's early summer, so let's throw some crops in here, some fields. Let's do, say, 5 by 15, a couple 5 by 15s, and see what we have in store for us seed-wise. See if our third building is done. Yeah, all of our buildings are built. So now it's just these. And our crops are almost ready to be planted. Whether we get them in this year will be a good question, whether that happens or not. Okay, so we've got 2 fields that are ready to go. And I don't know if we have any seeds here. What do we got? We got cabbage and we got squash, so pretty much the same deal as normal. So we're gonna have to figure out how some of these new things work, like the hemp and all that kind of stuff. But that's okay. We can do that. Just getting used to this new menu. It's bigger now, so there's more. Have to look a little not used to where everything is. That's okay. That is part of the fun. Okay, so we would need some rope before we can build any of those manors or anything like that. And we clearly need a bit more food happening here. But that will come. Let's see here. What do we want to build first, I guess, is the question. Food production's never a bad idea. We do have chickens, so we should probably put a pasture in of some kind. Maybe just over here we'll put in a nice big pasture. What else have we got? Mix flour from grain. We don't have any grain yet. Oil press extracts oil from olives and harvested sunflower, flax, cotton seeds, and whale blubber. None of which do we have yet. So, I guess the question is, how do we start getting these things? Are we going to have to go through the whole process and build a dock in order to get all this stuff? And we're going to throw an herbalist in. Bundling shed. Shore house. Sand can be dug up for further processing at a glasswork, and frogs and turtles can be found. What? We can make some candles. The mulberry grove, where you can harvest mulberry leaves for silk production. Okay, so we could start with a bit of that, I guess. I don't know if we've got the population to do that yet, but you know what? Let's live a little. Let's find out. And we're going to throw one of those in. So that's our first kind of new colonial building. And it doesn't look like we got to getting our fields planted this year. That's okay. Just get all this stuff picked up. And our storage yard is probably getting full. So we're just going to put another little stockpile in back here. Busy, busy, busy people. We've got 15 grown-ups, we got 14 kids. And we got lots, like no end of materials here. We do got 836 food units. So I think we're good for the winter. Picking all that noise up. See how we're doing for production. Pretty good, pretty good. And the winter hits. Have a few coats. I found that coats don't really matter very much unless they do differently in this mod, but generally you can wait. You don't really need coats. It's more about getting everybody super happy. Or if you're going to have them going really long distances, then you might want them, but other than that, you don't really need them, I find. Or at least not too early on. And our firewood is up to capacity. We can even crank that up. The only thing with danger with cranking it up, if, as you know, if you've played it all, is if you put it too high, then there's no more logs left. You have to keep creating new, cutting down more trees to keep up. So, and our chickens can go home to roost. See what I did there. Okay, so people are going to settle in for the winter. We've got our basic needs kind of met. I got our mulberry grove starting up. Oh, we need mulberry leaf. I don't know how we gather that. How do we gather mulberry leaf? Let's see. Maybe one of these buildings will tell us. You know, this is the part where it's like, hey, you should have maybe actually looked this stuff up before you started. But no, it's not how we're doing this. Not today. He says, being all tough guy, and then 10 minutes from now I'm going to be like, okay, now I need to go and check the mod notes so if I can figure it out. All right, I'm just looking through the various items here to see what's what. Got our ropery, we got our silk worm hut. Got our weavers. Yeah, really, this is probably more a gathering type thing. So I'm just checking our resource production to see if I can figure out how one would go ahead and find mulberry leaf. I don't have the slightest idea. But that's what we're waiting on to finish that. So we have our chickens. We have our people. Should probably throw a couple more houses in to get our production increased. Maybe a nice stone house or two. I like the stone house. A bit partial to them. They do use up a lot of resources, but they look so pretty. And we'll cut a few of these trees down. Oh yeah, we need someone to work at the herbalist. Herbalist, there you are. Yeah, they're moving quick. Moving quickly. Yeah, something tells me we'll get a lot further ahead if we actually build a dock so that we can start importing some of these things that we might need. Because, again, I don't have any idea how one would get any kind of mulberry leaf. Should really have checked that out. And I will check that out. Darn it. Apologies for this in the middle of the thing. Just checking the description there, and that'll give us some ideas. Okay, and back to things we go. Sorry about that. So yeah, I've got my little list up here. It's probably going to end up being some kind of a crop type thing or something like that. Okay, so we've got our people building our crops. I'm going to make a break for the shore here. We're going to put in a bridge. There we go. There's our bridge. It's going to go in up there. And we are going to build us a dock. Menus, so many menus now. And that would be in our trading menu. There we go. It's all angly. That's kind of fun. Okay, so we're going to get our people building that. Make that a priority for them, get this going. And clear out. I always like to clear out some space around the bridge and that so you can see where things are going to be built. And figure your stuff out. So that's where we asked them to build. We're going to put a little road in. Where's our bridge? Is going to be about there. So we'll just put in a dirt road for now. We'll upgrade that shortly. Or at some point. And we told the people to chop some logs down for us. We got lots of gatherers and such because we started on an easy map, so we can make use of that. Gather all the stone that's lying around. Some deer hanging around. And you can see our two fields are in the ground, crops in the ground. This thing's still not done being built because I don't think it will until we get that mulberry leaf. Gosh, there's an awful lot of things here. I think it's going to be highly dependent on some kind of seeds, getting seeds. Unless there's another way to get seeds that doesn't involve... that doesn't involve buying them. I'm going to put a little tiny orchard here just to see if there's any different... if we get any kind of choices here as a result of our orchard. What we're given. Alright, so we've got most of the log that we need. We've got most of our... well, no, we don't have most of our stone. We have a small amount of our stone. Should probably put in another stockpile over here so our dudes don't have to go quite so far. And what do we have? Four choices here. Pear and apple. A little boring, but that's okay. That's not the mod's fault, of course. Orchard. Orchard, guys. Yeah, there's so many things in this list, it makes it really tricky to figure out where everything goes. I'm sure you would get used to it quickly. Where are my orchard dudes? Got all that. Gatherers, farmers. Where's the feather dudes? There they... oh, farmers, I guess, right? Of course. Of course. Alright, so now we're just waiting on the completion of the bridge, which is now done, and then I guess we're waiting on all this resource to be cleared out. Just so we can see what we're doing. And for those guys to pull all those resources for us. Alright, maybe we need to crank up our priority on this stone here. Come get all this stone, you guys. That's what we need. Clearly my children have been playing with my mouse using my computer. Should never let like 10 or 12 year olds near your computer. They're like, it's like a biohazard by the time they're done with it. Okay, so now we're kind of crawling a little bit here. Yeah, let's get this done first. Once the stockpile's in the ground, they won't have to go quite as far to move things, so that'll make life easier for us. And it'll also, of course, speed up moving things to the trading post as we need it. So we've got more than enough iron. It's just the stone that we're waiting on there. And everything over here is moving along all copacetic and fine. Our storage barn still got lots of room. Our farmers are moving things in. Oh, we're not going to build a stone road. I normally build a stone road, but I want to use all that stone. I don't want to slow down that trading post right now, so. Then, of course, we'll have to give them something to actually sell. But as long as we can buy a couple of things just to figure out what we're doing and have a look at stuff, that'll be kind of what we need. So, oh, I guess we could crank up to 10, can't we? Go even faster. There we go. So we got almost enough, more than enough stone there to finish this now. Of course, we've cranked up the priority over there, so we need to do that. So yeah, get back to building this thing. Oh, there we go. We have all our stone. We just need some iron. And that'll start getting moved in. Again, it's not all in this stockpile right here, so... but it won't be long. And then we'll just need our builders, and then we're good to go. Then once that's done, we'll sell them to build a house or two over in this area. But I don't want to interrupt the builders. Goodness knows they would try to start building that other one, and then we'll be sitting here forever while they make up their mind what they want to build first. So yeah, from what I can see for the notes for this mod is that it's fairly extensive. There's a lot of things. Almost it becomes a new game at some point, it would seem. Like, there's a lot more production and production chains and that kind of thing. But we'll see how all that plays out, I guess. Okay, so now we have a trader. So let's put at least two or three guys there. And here's our inventory of things that we're sending out. And there's all kinds of stuff and things. Well, guess we'll see what that looks like as soon as we get our first trader coming to visit us. So, one thing that we didn't do was build any kind of hunters, which were usually good for bringing in. Some meat, which we can then sell fairly quickly and make some money off of that. We could have put an apiary in to make the honey and the candles and that kind of stuff. I guess we could do that. Oh, that's big. That's a big apiary. Alright, and of course now we're increasing production far past what we're capable of actually sustaining, so it's going to slow things down. Let's get a couple more houses in there. Crank our population up. Fend off our eventual starvation. Right now we just want to see how things look. Alright, so far no boats in sight. Watch, I bet you the first boat we get is going to be a super boring one. Well, that was kind of negative, I guess, but with my luck, that's what it'll be. There we go, our hunting lodge is going in. And there we go, hunters. We got two houses here. Throw a third one in. We're going to create weird population booms, but you know, what are you going to do? So, with any luck, we could very shortly have some kind of trader coming in, and maybe they'll give us a few more of those things that we need to get our production ramped up. Keep an eye on what's in our storage barn. We could sell some firewood. That's probably a quick and easy way. A lot of people are big on that whole firewood economy thing. One of our orchards is infested. Oh, unless it's the, orchard, sorry, not crops. Burn it all down, cut it all down. I didn't really want the orchard anyway. Just grew it for the effect. Okay, so we're going to take some of our firewood. A lot of other people just ignoring the road. Yeah, it's not any faster, so thanks, but So yeah, we'll get some firewood over there, and that way if there is something to buy, we can buy it. Get moving forward. And then we've finished building our apiary, so we could put in a beekeeper who will produce honey for us. Or we could produce beeswax. Let's make some beeswax, guys. This is kind of exciting. Oh, and of course we haven't built a blacksmith. Playing like a rookie today, folks. Like a total rookie. We will need a blacksmith if people want to use tools ever again. Let's make that a priority. Man, you don't play for a couple weeks and it all goes away. All of that knowledge in your head. Gone. And of course we have no stone. Ugh, such a rookie. You can watch this video as an example of how to just get it all wrong. But nobody's died yet, so that's a plus, I guess. Here, come and get all that stone, you guys. And then we can build you some tools. Of course you have no tools to get the stone with, so it's going to be painfully slow. What's going on here? Do we have our... No, not yet. Come on, traders. I'm following the river to see if I can see the trading ball. We're really far down the river, too. So from the time they hit the map till the time they get to us, it's going to be a long time. So we got about 1,000 units of food. But our population's growing, and that's what we had before. It's a little concern... A little bit of concern there. We do have our hunting lodges now, so they can theoretically bring in some more food. And how are we doing in blacksmith world? No clothes now. No clothes for anybody. No warm clothes. Because, you know, screw those guys, right? We don't have any sheep or any wool anyway, so not much we can do. Okay, so now we have a blacksmith to make some tools. Solve crisis number one. And we've got our 300 firewood here. We've got our woodcutters ready to cut some more wood. So even though our firewood reserve is low, and we've also got the stone houses, so if anyone does start freezing, they can go into the stone houses and get warm. What we don't have is a white mulberry grove. And that's what we really, really want. Hey, a merchant. Okay, I'm gonna pause just so I don't miss anything with our friend the merchant. And he has nothing. This is Damon Gomer the smuggler. He's got some ale. Yeah, great. I don't think we need any ale right now. Every visit, bring us some tobacco, bring us some mead. Yeah, bring us a little bit of everything. How about that? And you may go. I was really hoping that would be a bunch of seeds. Oh, he's going that way, so the river comes from this end. Hadn't even considered that. Oh, so we're close to the beginning of the river. So that's all right. Okay, come on, tool guys. Let's go make with the tools. Shouldn't take too long, and we should have some tools back. And we're back to the spring, and we still got about 800, 900 units of food. So our food is looking okay. Now, we should have some beeswax piling up. So you can mind your beeswax. That's not funny. Okay, so let's make something with that. So, what can we make with that? Oh, and we can build a shore house. I guess we can do that. A chandlery is used to make candles out of beeswax or whale blubber. That's what we want. Chandlery. You're a chandlery. That's, again, not funny. I don't know why he keeps telling jokes. They're not funny. There, we can fit it right there. So that's one of the new resources that we can get. And then we could look at putting in a shore house. And I don't know if that requires being on the actual ocean or if it just... Nope, it looks like we're good. We can do it on the... We're going to build one right there. And it just needs some logs. So I guess we also need to make sure there's some logs. Harvest a bunch of trees from there. Our tool situation has been sorted. And we need someone to work in the... We need a chandler. There we go. We have a chandler now. And he can build candles out of either beeswax or whale blubber. Let's go with beeswax. Now, I don't know whether the candles have any usage to people or whether they're just a trade good. That I don't know. But I know that we'll be trading some of them as soon as we can. Because they're probably worth something. And there we go. We've got 70 beeswax units in our chandlery. And we've got our tools going. We've finished building our... or shore house. So who works at the shore house? Let's see. Some kind of digger. Shore house worker. Oh, a grove tender tends to white mulberry trees. Aha. The guy who made the mod is watching this and laughing at me right now because I'm doing such a terrible job of figuring out the things. Because I didn't read. Okay, so we will get to the glassmaker. Right now, we need to find the shoreman. That's him there. All right, so grove tender is what we need. So we need a grove. How does one make a grove? Orchard, crops, pastures, gathering huts, oil press, apiaries. Unless it's an actual resource building. Grove. Weavers. Silkworm huts. Ropery. Yeah, okay. So, I guess it's... I did okay. I had it right. Until we have that, we can't really do anything with it. I don't know how one gets the mulberry, but we will. Damn it. If it's the last thing we do. Alright, so let's put some candles to work. What do these people got? Oh, they lots of food. We're good food-wise. Although, not a lot of food stored for the winter. Once again, we better get on that pretty quick. Put in some bigger fields or something. Maybe another gathering hut. Firewood's low. Everything's low. We're terrible. We're terrible at this game. Let's put in a gathering hut. There. And I think more fields once again. Maybe a bigger field this time. And in a perfect world, we'd have like four more trading hut, so we wouldn't be sitting here waiting for the trades. It's probably what we should have done. You know what? Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's get a little crazy here. Let's put in another trading post in. I'm doing it. I don't even care. I'm that kind of maverick. I'm mavericky. I'll do it. Let's build some more, put some more squash in there. A couple more houses. He plays like he's drunk. I'm not drunk. I don't even care. I'm just doing it. I'm doing it. That's all. All right. So how are things going over here at our little... Where is he? That building is almost invisible. Oh, it's pretty small, that's all. Digging sand. Someone come in and digging some sand? Yeah, he's digging sand. I can see him. Yeah, we almost didn't make it through the winter food-wise, so... We're gonna put a few more folks on the job this year. It's a big field. And our blacksmith has hit his limit, used up a bunch of logs to do it. That's okay. Look at our little apiary here, producing all that beeswax. And then the beeswax being converted into candles, and there's another merchant. Yay! Hey, what do you got? Pea coats. Oh, nice coats. And the candles are worth a decent amount. Get a few of those. We'll trade a few of those. Let's do that. Let's make that trade. And what do we got from these guys? These are just all kinds of coats. That's lovely for later in the game, but we don't need any of it right now. We need rar materials. Rar materials. But our people will be dressed lovely and look nice when we're all said and done. So... That's, I guess, a positive thing. Still short on trees. We have yet to put in a single forestry building of any kind. How are we doing in our giant squash field? We're hoping to produce enough squash to keep everybody going. Look at this, just cooking along here. Trading post is almost built. Number two. This guy's name is Well. Well has become an adult and is working as a laborer. He's Well. And our orchard is just sitting. We're not doing anything with it. That's okay. We got a few more laborers. We're going to get a few more farmers on the job. How's Sand Dude doing here? Digging sand. Oh, we've got some sand now. So, what we also need to do is... figure out how we're gonna get the people. Oh man, we didn't leave any room to get through there. That's okay. We will just go over here, I guess. Poor planning. Okay, so let's put in another resource of some kind. We've got our shore house, so we need a glassworks. And there's the glassworks. Let's put in a glassworks. Oh, it's beautiful. And hey, we're actually pulling those crops out of the field pretty early, which I like. And we've got some a bit more stored for the winter than we did last year. Should probably have a storage barn closer to here so that we get all of it out of the field. Come on, dudes. Get the rest of it. I'm not sure how long squash lasts. We're at -3. Won't be a lot longer, and there it goes. Okay, so we didn't get all of it out of the field this year, but next year we will. Got a few more workers on the job now. More gatherers. Alright, so our food is going back up again, and our second trading post is now built. All right, let's see if we can get some candles over here. And that's all we really have to trade. I don't want to go crazy on the firewood, since we haven't really amped up that as a resource yet. And we're eager to see how all this works out here. Building our glasswork. So this is one of the unique buildings to this mod, which is pretty cool. Kind of digging it so far. And that's one of the other new buildings there, of course, the chandlery. It's pretty slick looking. And then we had our shore house. Get used to all these names. Hooray, look at that. Our glassworks is built. And so now we're going to need a glassmaker. Could even put two glassmakers in. And they have a choice between using sand and firewood, sand and coal, or sand and fire bundle, which I believe can be made from organics, which we don't have. Great, that's what we need, is something using a lot of our firewood. So we'll just cut some more trees down for the time being, and we're going to pretty seriously think about putting in a forester's lodge. And so we did. So they've got a little bit of firewood and a little bit of sand, and they will begin the process, and maybe we'll sell some glassworks, some glass. And then, do we do anything else with the glass, or is the glass just the glass? Let's see if we've got another building that fancifies things with glass. Blacksmith, tailor. Doesn't look like it, but I'm sure we can find out from our... Once we get to that point, we should be able to see it in one of the listings on the trading post. Sorry, stopped halfway through my thought. That's probably annoying if you're trying to listen to me. Alright, sorry this is taking a little while to get things up to speed, but I'm sure once it is, it will be just fantastic. And everyone will be so pleased. And we have no production because why? Why do we have no production? We have sand, we have firewood. Materials required to perform work are not available. Yes, they are. It just took a minute to catch up. We've got a merchant. Okay, look, we've got some lamp oil. Oh, lamp oil is pretty super expensive. That's crazy. And we can trade our firewood and our candles. This guy's a materials trader, so he's going to have some of the things we want. He's got silk cocoons. We might want some of those. He's got cloth that we can use to make into things. Hemp. Rope. Flax. Yeah, this is all stuff that we want. And then the completed stuff, not so much. And let's order every visit. Dude, next time you come back, you bring us those things. I'm not grabbing any lamp oil, though. I don't know. Maybe that heats us up, keeps us warm. So many questions I don't know the answers to. You guys probably all know the answers to them because you read the mod notes before we started. Not me. Just playing. I don't care. I've told you, I don't care. Storage. We could make some... build one of these back alleys. Oh, that's what we need there, you know. It needs some of that lamp oil. Okay. We're going to do that at some point. We don't even care. So, what else do we not have? We got a bundling shed where we can create the organics. We've got the shore house we built. Frogs and turtles, I guess, for food. Or organics, if you will. The glassworks, which we've got. Our mulberry grove. Our ropery, where hemp and flax are bound into rope. Well, we might want to build those at some point. Silkworm hut raises silkworms to make silk. So let's put a silkworm hut in, because that sounds cool. But we need 10 silkworms. We have some cocoons. I don't think that counts. And we have another trader. He's got tools, coal, and firewood. Boring, boring, boring. Got fire bundles. Yeah, we don't need any of this stuff. Not really. I mean, we do, but nothing we want to trade for just yet. So let's dismiss him. So we are getting low on resources again. Let's grab some more of this stone that's lying around here. I suspect that a mine and a quarry will be needed, because it seems like there's more things to build and more things that will need things. Autumn. Oh, we still don't have enough. We clearly need a storage barn closer. Or perhaps a new one of these new buildings. A root cellar. Fruits and vegetables. That's what we need. Maybe it needs to be built into a hill as well. Because it doesn't seem to want to go on flat land. Come on, root cellar. What's your problem? There we go. Kind of has to be in the hill, it looks like. It's a little closer. We'll build one of those. Yeah, we will. It's just how we do this, I guess. Okay, so onwards and upwards. Our silkworm hut can't be complete until we've got some silkworms. We bought some silkworm cocoons from somebody here. I don't know where they ended up. Or maybe we didn't and we thought we did. Or maybe they were taken and eaten. I don't know. We've got some glass now. We can trade some of our glass. Let's trade 40 units of glass, because that's just what we do. This guy's digging up some sand. There's our little root cellar. It's done being built now. What we really need to do is get more dudes on this job. They're at it right away this year. Our goal is to bring that whole crop in, you guys. Okay, so we've got our candles being made. We've got our apiary, which is feeding the chandlery. We could also use it for honey if we decided that was easier. Looks like we're storing some of our stuff in our root cellar now. That's pretty cool. Our silkworm hut will not be completed until such time as we have silkworms, which I guess maybe will show up, I don't know, with the animal guys? Who's to say? The glassworks is up and running, so we've made some progress. We can at least look to that and say, ha, take that. Game that didn't have those things. Hey, look at that. So there's 5 silk cocoons and 5 linen and 500 sand units. And sand is pretty cheap, so we could get a bunch of that. And our glass is worth a little bit more. And our candles are... Oh, look at that. We can buy another 100 units of sand if we so desire. So let's make that trade first, and then let's say to these guys, bring us silk cocoons, bring us cotton, bring us flax, bring us hemp, sure lamp oil, rope, sand. Yeah, just bring it all. Every time. Until we've figured out how to use all this stuff. And back we go. Cool, okay. Sort of feels like we're figuring it out. A lot of stuff here. And I'm feeling like a lot of it's dependent on getting some seeds of different types. I could be wrong about that, and maybe there's just something super easy that I am missing. Plant wild trees, plant fruit trees, plant flowers. Maybe that's what I need to be doing is planting some... Oh, look at that. Town apples. So these are decorative, though. These are not going to be... Okay. Never mind. I got excited for a second because I thought maybe I could get ahead of things here. But nice, there's lots of decorative items in that, which is pretty cool. Another merchant, yay! Okay. What do we have here? We have hemp and tobacco leaf. Let's get some of that going on. So, we are gonna trade. Take a bunch of this stuff. And this is the second guy that we've had. Second time this guy's come by. Okay, cool. So now we have some hemp coming in. We've got some tobacco leaf coming in, so we could create a ropery? A ropery. There. Take that. Okay, the weaver makes linen cloth and silk out of flax, cotton, and silkworm cocoons. So we're actually buying an end product as opposed to a resource like we thought. Like I thought. You didn't think that, you knew. And we're out of trees once again. And we didn't bother to put any foresters on the job, so there's no trees there. Where's my foresters? Still having problems with this menu because it's so gargantuan and hard to figure out. Plant, don't cut. When we want trees cut, we will cut them ourselves. Thank you very much. Cut all those trees. And cut all these trees. And some of those trees. Okay, so. We are progressing. We are moving forward. We probably don't have enough houses. We should do a bit more in that regard. And of course, we're using up all of the available logs now, trying to build all these buildings, as well as creating new buildings. And hey, look at that. Tobacco leaf guy. And... this guy's been here before. I'm gonna dismiss him. So we have 100 hemp. We've got 440 tobacco leaf, which we just bought a bunch because it was cheap. We haven't bothered to figure out whether it was an end product or not. There's a roper. Mr. Roper's on the job now. I'm just looking through my guys to make sure everybody's doing the stuff they're supposed to do. And we're doing a little bit better job of getting this field done. Weavers. There. We have a weaver. So we can either produce linen from flax, we can produce it from cloth. From cotton or from cocoons. We've got 5 cocoons. We could start with cocoons. And the rope can either be made out of flax, which is not as good, or hemp, which is better. So we're going to do that. Make a little bit of each of those. And then we just need to wait for those items to show up to those guys. Okay, 7 years, but we are starting to make some progress. And the people look very lovely and jaunty. They've got a bit more color to them than the normal people did, which is pretty cool. Still not sure how we get our silkworms. I'm still not sure how we get our mulberry leaf. If I don't find the answers to these questions, and you know them, perhaps you could share with us. The windmill does flour from grain. We don't have grain yet. An oil press, so you could make oil, probably the lamp oil. The bakery. Got a sugar house for sugar cane. We could send the ship out to the sea, and we've got a dairy. Again, I don't think any of those are going to help us right at the moment. We've done a pretty good, decent job of building most of these buildings now. Not all of them, but a lot of them. Our ropery is busy roping, building some rope. And our weavers are probably waiting for more silk cocoons. We didn't give them very many to start with. So yeah, we're a little short on the animals. We also haven't had anybody come by to try to sell us animals yet. Which, once you have them, is annoying because they keep coming back and selling them. But currently, we don't have any of those, so it would be nice. Now, the tobacco leaf. What do we do with the tobacco leaf? Do we turn that into anything? Or do we just enjoy it? Just have a nice smoke. Okay, Inn and Garden, we've got a brewery, we've got a winery, a distillery, a curing barn. This is where tobacco is air cured before smoking. Oh, we need one of those, for sure. Maybe that allows us to use the tobacco. Our town setup sucks here, people, I'm sorry about that. But again, we're mostly building this just to see what the what is, as opposed to being actually used for any great length of time. And our food stores are low once again. We could put another field in, I think. Make that a priority so that we can get that in. That one squash. No, we do have a squash. Let's make that cabbage. There, we have a curing barn. We've got a curer working in the curing barn now. We're going to crank that field up. It seems to be working to get more stuff out of the field. And so they, okay, so they're going to take the tobacco leaf and they're going to make pipe tobacco. Which I guess may work like alcohol, may increase people's happiness, and we may be also able to sell some of it. Alright, and we've got our boring guys back. He's not trading us for anything that we're particularly interested in. I guess we could buy some logs. Not the worst thing in the world to have. Like to see the animal guy show up to see what that's all about. And it would be nice to get this silkworm hut up and running, or this mulberry thing up and running. Clearly I'm just missing something. Feel free to mock me mercilessly for missing all of these things. As I said before. Oh yes, no, let's not get caught by a log limit of any kind here. Just keep growing trees. Let's grab all that stone. And we are running low on food, hopefully. Once this harvest comes in, that'll change a lot of that. Still think that root cellar might be too far away. I'm gonna wuss out and put a storage barn over here, just to be safe. So it looks like our candle production's pretty steady, our glass production's doing great. Food production's okay, it's not brilliant. We're still leaving a bit of food in the field, which we should never do. If we finish this storage barn soon, we could get the rest of it out of the field probably by shortening that walk back and forth. But that will be next year's problem, apparently. Oh, there we go, we got it up. Maybe they'll still get some of it in before it all disappears on us. Not a lot, though. Well, a little bit. Okay, so there you go, a little bit of that. What do you have for us here? Oh, look, seeds, broccoli, fun. And there's some cream that we could probably turn into some kind of cheese or something like that. Oh, of course, we don't really have enough cash for the broccoli seeds right now. But that's okay. We'll get them next time. And, oh, here we go. Here's our list. This is what we wanted to see. We can order some bison. Some llamas. Here's all our different seeds. Better pause things here. Slow things down. Barley is new, of course. There's a few new seeds here. Beetroot. Carrot. Chickpea. Cotton would be a great one to have. Mulberry. I wonder if that's our mulberry. That's red mulberry, not white. Hemp seeds would be great. Oh, goodness. Look at all these seeds. Man. This is fun. Okay. Oh, and look at this. We've got our... There's some bamboo and barley, like the finished products. Man, look at this. All right. There's our mulberry leaf. That's what we need. So many things we need here. All right. So, I think what we're going to do is we're going to make a call on this. We're going to trade. We're going to... Every visit, all that stuff that we just checked, bring those. And there'll be more, I'm sure. What has this guy brought us? Oh, look at that. Some sugar cane. And some extra food, which never hurts. So, we're gonna buy a bunch of this stuff just to see what we can do with it. Especially the sugar cane, I guess. Oh, don't overtrade. Oh, and let's trade, and then let's see. Yeah, again, look at all this stuff that he's got. So he brings the more of the completed goods, but that's okay. All right, we're going to send him on his way, and we're going to dismiss him. I think what we're going to do is, because there's so much stuff here, we're going to maybe do a second video where we kind of tackle the production chains and things like that now that we're pretty much set up. Though we're not fully set up, but we've at least got some stuff up and going. So thank you for fumbling through that with me. I apologize if it was painful for you. Hopefully it wasn't, and it was fun. I had a good time. As always, we are Ware Games, and we love any kind of feedback you have, even to tell us that you didn't love it. If you did love it, that's great. And we enjoy bringing them to you, so thank you very much for watching, and we'll talk to you next time. Great. Thanks. Bye.